Star in the lead role on CBS's hit show MacGyver, opening up tonight about an extremely toxic work environment on the set of the show. The actor says during season one, he actually contemplated suicide, Rick.
Astrid in the ATL joins us now with the details.
He just goes by Ian, I heard now.
Marietta native Lucas Till has been playing the title role of MacGyver on CBS's reboot since 2016.
Relax. It's not our first rodeo.
Astrid in the ATL visited the MacGyver set on many occasions.
People really weren't sure how long it was going to last.
Myself included.
Yeah? Why? Tell me, what were the doubts?
Well, I mean, I just didn't know that people were going to receive me very well.
On the outside, things were going great for the local star, working in his hometown and enjoying the success of a hit show.
Yeah, it was actually really nice.
But things aren't always what they appear. In a recent Vanity Fair interview, Lucas reveals he considered taking his own life. In an expose on his former boss and showrunner Peter Lenkov, Lucas says he endured numerous instances of body shaming, on-set verbal abuse, and bullying. The actor says, "I was suicidal that first year on the show because of the way he made me feel. But the way he's treated the people around me, that's just my breaking point."
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Okay, everybody needs to calm down.
Lucas blames the former showrunner for creating a hostile work environment. The 29-year-old claims he brought his concerns to CBS several times, including writing a 5-page letter to HR earlier this year. Lucas recalled how he once had to wear a hospital gown, and Lenkov said, "My legs were expletive hideous, and we could never show them again." Local experts tell me you may be in a toxic work environment if you face daily major stresses, if you constantly feel devalued, and if you begin and end your day dreading your job. Aside from MacGyver, Lenkov also oversaw Hawaii Five-O and Magnum PI. Lenkov was fired earlier this month. At first, he denied any and all allegations of abuse. Since then, he's apologized.